This is a GoHamRadio.com exclusive.
Welcome to another pop-up interview. We got an exclusive interview here with Adonis DaHottest, and we call them pop-up interviews because we are tapping back in with some of the artists that we have already tapped in with in the past. We're going to wait to give you all these new artists later on in the year on Street Talk, but right here, we got sitting next to me, the Don himself. AD, welcome to the hotspot.
What's going on with you?
I think the last time we seen each other, he was fresh out, and I was like, well, let me count the days, and I was like, well, we lost a year, so it's like you got a minus one, plus one, carry to see. I know you looking extra fresh, though.
Oh, yeah, I appreciate it. Appreciate it.
I had to make sure I put on my nice fancy pants tonight so that I can match his flash.
Right. You know, I just had to put my uniform on this.
Dripping, man. I wear one ring. It takes a statement. It's the only statement it needs to make, correct? Wedding ring, right?
Right.
Oh, well, welcome to the studio. Man, I don't believe it's been since 2017, but I guess we'll go with your word. We'll just say I've had a few babies in between more on the way, and we just gonna keep it at that.
I think what it was actually 2018, but I was out for probably maybe about 4 or 5 months or something like that. So I was still, you feel me? I was still getting my feedback way.
Still on probation probably, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
See, you're not on probation anymore.
Nah, definitely not. Definitely not.
I gotta like that, right? You can kick back, relax a little bit.
Yeah,
he can get in his new whip and drive around town.
Skirt.
So we're gonna keep it right here where we got you in the hot seat for the latest release, your EP, East Daygo Nights.
Yes.
This isn't your first project. You've had many projects. Like we've known, you've been doing this for many years, since you were a tween, since before you even hit the teenage years.
Definitely.
So much so you even got a teen yourself who is continuing the torch of rapping.
Definitely. Danae DaHottest.
Danae DaHottest, man.
She probably listening right now too.
What's up, shout out Danae? Oh, we gotta get that interview in, you know.
Oh yeah, she coming for sure. I just wanted to get, you feel me, like the whole school thing. Like I wanted to focus.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
So and when that's the summer what you need come, to do. Danae, focus on school. Focus on school.
Definitely. So when the summer come, you know, she got a little room to work with.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, GoHAM Radio, we're here. We're like neighbors, downstairs.
Right. Definitely.
So East Daygo Nights, it's an EP. It's not a full project. Why did you decide to do an EP instead of a full project this time?
Really, it's just like the time that we're in. You feel me? And I was talking to one of the executives at Empire Records, and he was telling me, he was like, you got to think, like, we're living in a different era. Like people's attention span, it's not like it used to be. You feel me? Like, with the full-length albums, like, you feel me? Like, they get sidetracked. You feel me? And if you notice, the last album that I put out upon my release was, like, I think it was, like, 23 songs or something like that. I mean, you know, it was a classic, though. Like,
I mean,
like,
I'm like, 20
telling me,
out of 23.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I mean, it's
the skits, and it's
definitely probably a couple songs I probably would have took off now. You feel me? Like, me going back looking at it, but it actually served its purpose. You know, I had people, like, that was really waiting on me. And even before I had to go away and all that, like, I hadn't really put out nothing. So, you know, I felt like they deserve to get that from me. But nowadays, it's EPs and singles and shit. So I'm really about to be flooding the rest of the year with just EPs, literally.
So wait a minute. So we're never going to get another album from you again?
Definitely going to get another album. But I mean, you know, just right now, I'm going to just keep it short and sweet. You know, just reclaiming my spot. That's all.
Your vocabulary.
Right.
Reclaiming your spot.
Right,
so,
right, right.
Okay, what spot are you referring to?
Okay, when I say spot, I mean, you know, I've always been a king for sure. But when I say spot, I mean like the spot as far as like the listener's ear. Like you got to think, we got a whole generation of people who haven't really been a part of my journey, who haven't really seen me from a kid to now. Mm-hmm. So it's like I got to reclaim my spot in all the listeners' ears. Like it's a lot of new music going on. So you know, I kind of got to step on other niggas' necks real quick. Like, hold on.
So who do you feel is your competition then, I guess? Like, are you competing against the same people you competed against last year? Are you competing against Danae's competition? Where is your competition? Where do they lie? What demographic?
That's a good question. I mean, for me, I like to say, not to take nothing away from the local, you know, I mean, the other local rappers that's out here, but like I always see myself competing with the big heads, you know, like the celebrities, the Kendrick Lamars, the J. Cole's, mm-hmm. you feel me, like shit like that. Like that's who, when I go into the studio or when I'm writing, I'm thinking of them as my competition. Like, you feel me? I'm aiming high. Like, you know, so that's.
So, and by competition, it's really competition in the love of the fans, yeah, right? Because it's competition of the money.
Exactly.
Whose album are they going to buy?
Right, right.
Who versus who? Now, when it comes to the Kendrick Lamars and these rappers, they speak from the streets, but they also have a story to tell.
Exactly.
They more are poetic, you know, when they say these things. So you have a story to tell. You've been
right.
In and out on vacation. You know, you've started off in the industry young, been in and out of that, been in and out of the streets, just understanding really the dynamics of being a survivor, a
exactly.
street survivor is
right,
really what
right.
it is. And you're telling a tale of that, which not all rappers can do. They
right.
they speak of moments. They speak of moments of themselves. And
right.
even Pac spoke of moments of other people. But
yeah,
you
definitely.
You speak a lot of experiences that you have on your own.
Right.
How do you feel that compares with these your competition?
I mean, when you ask it like that, it's kind of, it's a wide range. Like it's a broad answer because really, like, as far as like the people that I'm really technically competing with, you mm-hmm. feel me? Because in my head, technically I'm competing with the celebrities. You feel me? They don't even mm-hmm. know me, but that's my, you feel me? That's my goal as far mm-hmm. as the, like, as far as my caliber of work, that's what I mean by competing with them. But like, if you're really talking about my real competition, it's like, people nowadays are just making music for the moment. Like you said, they like copying whatever sound is out right now. Me personally, I have no other choice but to write about what I go through. Even though I'm young, I come from that old school way of art. You feel me?
Was there ever any other option besides rapping?
Yeah, I mean, it's always other options. I mean, but for me, it was kind of like I grew up in it. Like it's embedded in my being. You feel me? So it's kind of like for me, that's all I ever really seen was music.
Do you see yourself doing music in 10 years?
I do. I was just talking to Elway about the fucking the E-40 and the two short versus battle.
Oh, yeah, but you're going to have you like Don Elway kind of
like
versus?
That's definitely going to be me and that nigga, like, mm-hmm. years from now. Like, you could just see, like, they still got the youth, and I'm like, hip-hop keeps you young, period, mm-hmm. definitely. But they still got that spark, though. Like, can't even take that away from me. I mean, I'm not just going to always just look to music for like my, you feel me, like just like my number one occupation, because now it's like I'm older now, so now I'm more aware of investing in real estate and shit like that. So
do you see yourselves, I mean, you're talking about those verses, I assume that you saw the Gucci Mane and the Jeezy verses,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I did see that.
And you saw the moment when he took it back and just said, you know, we're doing this because we're influencers.
Right,
we need
right.
to be better influencers, yeah, because we haven't been recognizing our power within the community,
right.
and it's been negatively affecting the community. Do you feel that you and Don are looking to aspire to be at that level, or do you feel you're already at that level within your own community?
I mean, we definitely have a voice. We definitely got a voice that they're listening to as far as the young cats and all that type of shit. Like, but I would definitely like to be that figure, like, you know, later on down the line. I mean, we still got some learning to do too,
mm-hmm.
but we are actually aware that we're becoming them type of figures mm-hmm. in our community. So yeah, definitely.
And you've influenced many people along the way,
right? Right.
Good and bad, you know, because yeah. that's just the
that's
way
how
of the
I go.
World,
yeah.
right? But still doing it. It seems like every now and then there seems to be a little bit of flack, or not even flack, I would say a little bit of jealousy.
Yeah, that come with it. For sure.
You know, from people who, I mean, I'm trying to think of a better word to say than that, but really it seems like people that you have met along the way sometimes don't support you in the manner that you would hope. And kind of have disrespect unnecessarily, and it's happened multiple times, and it seems like recently you decided to be a little more vocal about the public display of disrespect. Do you know
what
I'm talking about?
Nah, yeah, what you mean? That's what I was
gonna
ask you.
So I'm trying to be a little facetious here, but
nah, that's cool. Talk to me.
So,
talk to me.
You know, I follow Instagram. I follow y'all
yeah.
Instagram, and I've seen this little thing posted. I follow a couple of people's Instagrams.
Right, right, right.
Maybe they don't follow each other, but I may follow them. I'm Swiss. It's neutral territory over here. But
right.
I saw somebody had said something about Trey Five, which is a collective of individuals and an area that you represent,
right,
and had kind of questioned, what is that? It, more of like a fan saying, what is all this mention of something? And somebody responding, you know, just something new that had popped up and just kind of disregarded the group when somebody had inquired. And you reposted it, and I saw it, and I thought it was just kind of interesting because I've known you at least, you know, for 3-4 years, and it's always been the same.
Right.
So
right,
for this to occur, I guess, is my question. First off, why did this occur? And then your response was actually in a song that Roscoe happened to play before the show started, okay. Trey Five.
Okay, yes.
So maybe you kind of know who I'm referring to, what the situation is, and right. maybe you can give us a little bit of details. I'm being vague because I don't necessarily know the details. So maybe I can give a little bit of vague details and he can fill in the blanks.
Right, right, right.
So what am I talking about here?
I mean, obviously we're talking about the Skywalker cat, whatever. I mean, as far as all that, like, it's really kind of like an isolated incident. It's something that happened between him and a couple people from my section or whatever. And you feel me? Like, you know, I ain't gonna get too deep into it, but he chose to express himself via Instagram. Mm-hmm. You feel me? When he had my number, and really, you know, like, he wasn't even necessarily just talking about me, but he was being funny on disrespecting the part of town that I come from. So when he said that, like, you know, like, I, like, everybody know I take this Trey Five shit serious. So, mm-hmm. So I'm like, hold on. Like, you know, I got at him. You know, we had a couple words, and I told him, like, you know, you got to clear this up or I'm finna get on you. You mm-hmm. feel me? Like, for sure. Like, I already know I probably ain't going to see you nowhere or whatever. Like, you know, like, but since you don't want to talk and you don't want to, you feel me? You don't want to be a dose about this. Now I'm finna just get on record and just get on you. You feel me? But, you know, I ain't going to go too deep into that. We all see how that ended. Or whatever, like, you know, like, because, you know, like, really, I don't represent, that's not what I represent.
And that's what I'm going to say, because you seem to be elevating yourself. So yeah. To, you know, respond to something yeah. like that, it just seems kind of.
It had to bother me. Like, everybody was saying, like, hold on, AD, like, damn, like, that had to really bother you. And I mean, it didn't really
because
necessarily.
Because you went off on that. You gassed yeah. hard on that, like an yeah. 83 octane type thing right, on right, there right, and, right. like, set the whole internet on fire. Right, and right. I was just kind of like, well, wow, he doesn't usually beef like this, so
yeah, exactly.
It really seems to have touched you what it occurred, so that's why I was just wondering, you know, why would this individual even say something like that? Because then they used to be a little homie type
yeah,
thing?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like, for me, like I'm a man of respect, you feel me? I mean, you know, we all grown men, so it's like, for you to do something like that on your platform, so now I'm going to take my platform and I'm going to just do it, but I'm going to do it better, though, since you rap, too. And yeah, I mean, like, it probably would have been different if he wasn't a rapper. Mm-hmm. We probably would have been able to handle it behind the scenes. But since you rap, it's like, come on. I've been waiting on somebody to say something. Like, honestly, you feel me? Like, this is what I do.
But it wasn't, I mean, it was almost just like an appetizer because, yeah, I mean, definitely. Comparatively, if he really wanted to do an internet beef, even looking comparatively, he has like 2,000 followers versus you who right, have right, over 10,000 right. followers. Right. I mean, just the fact that you can have the opportunity to swipe up
right,
to listen
right,
to the
right.
song.
Right, right.
I mean, just shows by numbers.
Look, for me, I'm going to just end it on this. It's like, just like you said, it was an appetizer because I had part two ready already. I mean, I actually got it recorded. So I wanted okay. to see what he was going to drop. And if it was anything, you feel me, that I felt like I needed to respond to, I was going to hit him with that part two. But I heard his and I'm like, all right, we're just going to leave it at that. Like, you feel
which
me?
One, the first one or the second one?
It was the same song, but he just re-recorded it. He had to re-record it.
Oh.
Hey, she messy up. Yeah, nah, basically, left it at that, and it's just like, you feel me? Like I said, I don't promote that. Like, I don't promote the negativity, mm-hmm. you feel me? And, like, I know people, like some people are impressed by negativity, or some people thrive off of that. And really, honestly, like, a lot of people start paying attention to me after that. Mm-hmm. And it's like, damn, I've been dropping all this player shit the whole year. You feel me? Versace shirts. He's out of town in Miami, every other state.
On your
and
whole like, EMEF collab, basically.
Yeah, the whole MF collab. It's like, and it took me to get at this cat that was disrespecting me, and everybody got their ears open now. It's like, okay.
I mean, why are they looking for beef? I don't get it.
Exactly. It's like people thrive off of negativity, though. Mm. And, you know, I just left that where that was at. Obviously, he's not the caliber of rapper that I am, and I kind of felt like it was like on some. You remember when Mariah Carey and Eminem was beefing?
Oh yeah.
I kind of felt like I was. You feel like me? It's like I'm battling Mariah Carey. Like I'm talking to a wall. Like you feel me? But you know, it's cool. Everything is hashed out. You know, like. Yeah, I mean, my peoples and reached out to their peoples and all type of shit. So, you know, that whole shit squash. More power to that dude.
That's pretty decent. My people reached out to their people.
Yeah, you know, it's just, you feel me? More power to that dude. I hope he gets successful. You feel me? Just don't talk about nothing that got to do with me. You feel me? That go for anybody else, too.
All right.
You feel me?
Just throwing it out there.
Yeah.
Right?
Hella.
Insert mafia. So they've been banging all around the studio with that song. And that's not even on the album, is it?
Nah, I didn't want to end it. Like, you know, again, I don't promote all that. Right. You feel me? But it's like since I had them listening, it's like I was already gearing up to release a project anyway. Mm-hmm. But since that happened, I'm like, oh, shit, I'm pressed the button now. East Daygo Nights available now. So
there it is.
Yeah.
There it is. Now you got 6 tracks on that EP.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you have production all by the same person?
I actually got a production two of the songs on there, which is Easy and
your latest single.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. Easy is actually produced by a young cat that's from 35th Street, Lil Sav. So
okay,
shout out to Lil Sav. He did that and. Like This, which is the first track on there, is produced by a cat out of the Bay Area. His name is Mike, made the 808s. And I'm actually, I actually got something scheduled with him. I ain't even going to speak on that yet, but we got some shit coming up.
I mean, you can speak on it. You're comfortable, right?
Not yet, because I got so many other ventures and shit that I'm going through. So it's like, you know what I mean?
I'd rather
EP after EP.
Okay.
Like after this. Yeah, I mean, we'll get to that. EP after EP, though. I'm just dropping like every other month. I'm just full force. I got so many songs in the vault. It's ridiculous. So
you got somebody from the Bay. You got somebody right here from the block. There's 6 tracks. The other 4, are they split between those 2? Do you have some that you usually work with on there, some producers?
Yeah, the other 2 is cats that I just met on Instagram.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like Lil Zach on the track, actually.
Okay.
And I'm another one, I think it was Past Your Bedtime. I think that's like the second or third track. Shout out to Slim Slumper. Slim Slumper made that beat. So.
Okay. Nice. Yeah. And it's available on all streaming platforms right now, everywhere. So you can go and tap in with that. Also, so you've got the 6 on there, but you've got some features as well. So you've got KC on one of them.
Uh-huh. Shout out to KC.
KC. And the others?
It's Pretty Kai and KC. KC is actually, she's out of Oakland. Mm-hmm. And I met her when we did a venture out there in the Bay. We shot a couple of videos out there, me, Nia Mack, and Mike Berry, and Sincere. Shout out to Sincere.
Mm-hmm.
And, I actually met her during that period of time, and we did some music and shit. And that was just one of the songs that stuck with me. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, you know what, we got to do the video. But the thing with the video was she's all the way out there, and I'm out here. So our schedules wasn't matching.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when I got the cartoonist to just go ahead and just do a cartoon video to it. So
and who, shout out to the cartoonist, because that's the one who did the work for all your album artwork now,
definitely,
right? Just kind of like caught fire, right?
Yeah, definitely. Ooh, definitely.
That West Coast fire.
I would shout him out, but I don't want y'all stealing my whole look. So, I'm going to shout him out later, though. Everybody been trying to get that dude. They like, who doing your shit? And I even told him, I'm like, I'm not even finna tag you, bro.
Ooh, I'm being stingy.
Price is going up like a motherfucker.
Okay, you gotta get through AD to get the contact already. Well, speaking of KC, Miami, and all that, Nia Mack. So tell me all of that, because you have been rocking with them tough. I've seen you going on tour with them. I mean, tour. I would call it tour.
Oh, yeah,
I definitely would call it tour.
Definitely tour.
They've been living the tour life.
I've been seeing that
on a snap and all types of things. So.
Yeah,
tell me about that, because we've had Nia in the building. We've had Donna in the building recently.
Shout out Nia.
And they've just been having a blast. It seems like they've been rocking out with Mike Berry and doing a lot of production, releasing a lot of work, a lot of music videos, a lot of photo shoots, a lot of whole lot of everything. And I see you right there next to him, damn near twinning with Mia. I see y'all. It's like like the fly and the flyer,
right.
I don't even know which one gets the fly and the flyer outfit.
They it's just Versace like a, shirt land. Nah, that's man, it.
They got the shoes to match. It's a whole type of vibe out there. They really rock the Miami vibe. Nah,
definitely how I got hooked up with MF. It's MF too. Everybody always MF.
I'm like, let me take it's like MF.
Yeah, and it actually stands for Elite Music, Entertainment, and Fashion. So you
Elite Music, Entertainment, and Fashion. Yeah, so it's so MF, just MF.
Yeah, just MF. When you know how like Eminem name is spelled with the M&M, so basically so it's MF. Yeah, basically.
So, okay, so MF. So let me say it correctly. MF.
Yeah, everybody say it like that. I mean, you know, it's good. But now you know.
Nia correctly? Now MF.
I think I did see her correct you a little bit. I think she tried to like a little bit, but then she just let you just go ahead. And, but yeah.
I appreciate you breaking it down for me.
Right.
You can break it down for
me. Nah, because a lot of people want to know, and I do get a lot of them questions, like even on my social media, like people ask me, like, are you still signing Uncontrollable? Like, are you signing MF? What's going on? And basically, it's just a joint venture. I actually got hooked up with Sincere. Shout out to Sincere again. He's been putting together some wild productions for us and wild shows and shit. But I got hooked up with them through Nia Mac. So when I got out, she wanted me to start fucking with them immediately. But you know, I had to get myself together. So you know, once I actually started getting my money up and all that, I started seeing what they was talking about. And Sincere, he's been around forever. Like he was the one throwing dripping wet parties back in the day. He's been around like the work that twerk that parties and all that shit. So. Yeah, y'all remember that shit that worked that twerk that? Yeah.
Already got the crowd in the back. Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Everything, yeah.
So, Techos.
Sincere, J.E. Sincere, he's a legend. He's a legend. And Mike Berry, like I've always had words with him, and, you know, we've always, like, exchanged songs and shit back and forth, but it was actually cool to get to work with him, which was my first time in Miami when they flew me out there and shit, like, come on, we finna record and we shooting the video the same day.
Miami's like, the second home.
Yeah, not yet. Now Miami's the second home. We done been back and forth. Like multiple times in a year, except for the you know the whole COVID shit. COVID kind of fucked it all up, but that's second home. I can't wait to go back.
Man, he got a closet East Cut. His whole closet is like East Coast, West Coast, East Coast, right, West right, Coast. Right. Versace.
Right. White rags.
I'm like, oh, I guess white rags. I'm like, what do we just kind of wear solid shirts, dickies, jeans. We chilling out here.
That's what I'm saying. It's funny, though, because I was talking to my manager, Leslie Young, and she was like, yeah, you was doing all that player shit the whole year. Versace shirts, what they wanted you to go back to the white rags and the black beanie and all that. I'm like, I guess so. I guess that's what they wanted, because now I got their attention. So,
right. So now that you got their attention, what are you doing with it?
I'm just not about to let up at all. Like, okay, we got the East Daygo Nights out. And actually, this is the first time me announcing this project. But top of spring, I'm dropping A Night in Vegas. Produced by Notch P.
Okay.
Notch P of Slaps on Deck.
When is this being released? Say it again.
This is top of the spring.
Okay. Top of the spring. Okay.
It's really all the way done. It's mastered. I got like two videos ready to go. But it's just the
East Daygo.
Yeah, definitely.
Before the release date.
But the East Daygo Nights just was been catching fire. So I'm like, let me just keep promoting this real quick and, you know, drop one more video for that. And then A Night in Vegas is coming up next. And the unique thing about that project is I actually went out there for my daughter's birthday, my youngest daughter, Ditter Gang, aka Danny DaHottest. Mm-hmm. You feel me? I went out there for her birthday, and I connected with Notch P. And like, you know, I know Notch P from back in the day when he used to be at Dave Moss' house and all this shit. So I connected with him. We got a room on the strip, and we recorded like 15 bangers in like a night and a half, just back to back. I got all the footage for it too. I got all the footage. So yeah, I mean, y'all in for some shit this year. I ain't even gonna lie.
Man, the time lapse video on that would probably look
definitely
crazy.
Like that was a wild night. Like literally, like I tell him what type of beat I want, and he'll make it right there from scratch, or he'll tell me like, okay, you should do some shit like this, make the beat from scratch, and I'm right there like in the footage that we're gonna release, you can actually see me writing to the shit or freestyling to the shit. Like it's cold.
And that's all on that the next project.
The next one, yeah,
out.
Night in Vegas, produced by Notch P.
All right, the whole thing.
Whole thing.
Damn. And so you have music videos for how many on this project? Out of the six you have?
So I already dropped three. And I got one more that I'm going to drop in like a week or two to the easy track.
Okay. Yeah. Are you using the same videographer for each one?
Well, for this project, I just kind of just been bouncing around, just tapping in with a couple people. But for that night in Vegas, same dude shooting everything. Mm-hmm. So I got the same producer, same videographer and shit. That shit is like we going for the branding more this time.
Okay, I like it. I like it.
Yeah.
Now, are you doing a promo run for this EP in the meantime, or because you said you're dropping a lot of EPs this year? So what are you doing in between, just dropping them and no promo run, or what is the
really? It's like I mean, just like the way the world is right now, it's kind of hard to do our normal rollout. Mm-hmm. You know, so like the places that we can go. We still popping up, like we're going to Dallas, mm-hmm. like mid-February. So I mean, just in between Dallas, Atlanta, and Miami, we might pop back up in Miami. It's just like it's everything is very limited, and shit, I'm scared to catch the COVID too. Like you feel me? Like I ain't trying to be mingling right. too much too. So I mean, you know, like we doing what we can. Just like the internet helps a lot. So
I mean. How has COVID treated you over 2020? Have you been directly affected, indirectly affected, no effect?
I mean,
looking to get infected. Yeah, vaccinated.
A couple of my. I mean, vaccine. I don't know. I ain't fucking with the vaccine. I'm gonna have to see like a million more people get the vaccine first before I pop up. I probably still won't do it at all. They ain't finna trick me. But right. Nah, as far as me being affected. I mean, me directly, like, the only thing that's really affected, like, directly was just travel and just shows. Like, I haven't done a show in a while. And, I mean, we're actually about to do a couple shows in Dallas, but it's still not going to be, like, the same. Like, you feel me? Just because everybody else is still scared to come out, too. Like, but don't get me wrong. No motherfuckers are still out there partying and no masks. They don't care, obviously.
Atlanta.
But, yeah, Atlanta for sure.
They're going
out there. But it's like, I had a couple family members that caught the coronavirus.
But it's not something
to laugh. It's not. It's really not though. But I mean, they good though. But it's a lot of other people like my partners and like you know like people that I deal with like some of their family members actually passed away from this shit. Mm-hmm. So yeah. So I mean, this is a cold time that we're in. But yeah, I'm still rocking though. Like it actually kind of helped me like become grounded again. Honestly, like. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like it's some perks to it. It's the gift and the curse, really.
Staying home, getting your grocery on. I've been seeing your grocery shopping list, your takeout menu, your pickup menu.
Right.
I'm a little jealous,
right.
neighbor, because he has all types of lobster.
Oh, yeah.
At least twice a week.
Lobster gang.
Plus, he's got sea moss. He's got juicing,
right?
All types of things that he's just being stingy with, thinking like you're gonna look pretty. I can't look pretty too. Yeah, maybe I want some.
I'm trying to be a little healthy for the most part. I mean, just for the most part, like you know, I'm not like a super health freak, but I have noticed. Shout out to Fuel Thyself, which is you feel me, like my homie, my big homie, and his wife. They started the sea moss business, and it's called Fuel Thy Sales. If you follow me, you see me posting them all the time. But that sea moss shit is real, though. Like I started taking it top of last year before the COVID-19 hit.
Before the sea moss craze, actually.
Nah, right? yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. That's why I was, like, one of the first ones out of, like, my circle to really start using it. And I haven't been sick, not once, since then. And I'm a person, like, you know, like, my immune system... Like, it's kind of weak, but shit, obviously not no more. Like, it, and that's what it does. Like, it strengthens your immune system and all that. Though, you feel me? I let them tell you all the other shit, but that shit been working for me.
Do you think your diets contribute to that, or do you think that you've been going back and forth with your diet and the sea moss has been consistent? Just curious, because I don't really do the sea moss thing.
Yeah.
Others do the sea moss thing. Yeah. Shout out to Fuel Thy Cells. They actually have been putting... GoHAM Radio onto the sea moss thing.
Right.
Along with Iceland sea moss, both of them. So we've been trying little samples, and I tried to get to a bottle. Other staff members finished the bottle before other staff members could get to them. So
yeah, you got
to
get your own.
We are realizing that we just need to let let businesses know that we have a staff of 10 and they're savages. Savages. We can't keep snacks in the studio. We can't keep roaches in the studio.
Right. You don't want to keep them in there anyway.
Savages. Avocados. Yeah. You don't have to fight over the avocado.
Right.
But so with East Daygo Nights, you've got 6 tracks on there. What made you decide to pick these 6 tracks?
That's a good question because it was actually hard to narrow it down, honestly. Like, as a collective, you know, like I would just... you feel me, throw little small functions and like have little mini listening parties or what have you. And then we'll just play like the best 15 songs. And even then, like, I still had to like come back to myself, and then just, you feel me, like when I'm on a road trip or something, like I just gotta just single out some of the songs. Like, I don't know if I told you this before, but when I do music, like I see colors, like, so every song is a different color to me. Mm-hmm. Or some songs might be the same color. Mm-hmm. So with this one, just to make it all short, it's three colors two times. So, you know, that's six songs. Okay. So basically I got two of the same colors. You feel me? But I formed it all into a dope playlist where they can receive it. Okay. It's basically just like...
What are the colors?
I can't go that far with the colors. I'm gonna start sounding weird and shit.
But you know, we're gonna find all this out. I'll
let you into my mind a little bit. But it's kind of like my formula though. I just see what mesh with what, and I just wanted to make sure I put the right energy on there. I wanted to have a little bit of the West Coast. I wanted to have my little trap sound. And I wanted to get Letty something to listen to, so that's pretty much what I did.
Okay, is red one of the colors?
Red is actually not one of the colors.
Oh, not for the ladies? Sensual, getting in.
It was a little darker for the ladies. I kind of wasn't really like congratulating the ladies on this one. I was actually like just asking them a question, like, why are you so cold and why are you being immature?
Probably like blue.
But I mean, it was still in a way that they could receive it though, because it doesn't necessarily just have to be about the female. Like, I know some females feel the same way about us men. So, you know.
Yeah. We got one color knocked out.
I was just trying to figure out my strategy with the colors and shit. That's what's going on. That's a longer conversation right there. Nice. That's a different conversation.
Okay, we can save that for part two. But in the meantime, let's name one of the six songs. Do you know what they are in order? This is the quiz that I give, but I don't know if...
Let me see. I actually do, though. Like,
in order, though? Not just
in order, let me see. Yeah, I actually do, because I really thought hard about this list.
Oh, yeah, because they're the color scheme.
And weeding out the other songs. So
if you was asking about Sleep On Life... And are the colors next to each other, or do you mix the colors up?
On this particular one... See, let me see. She got me on the color. She got me on the colors. Look, come on, we going back to the track list. Cause now you finna get me started on everything. You about to really get me started, right? She almost had me though. You seen that though? Oh my kid, she almost had me though. She hella flipped it on me. Hella did. Okay, so the track list though. Okay, so we're going back to the track list in order. Okay, so track one is like this, and then we got track two, which is Past Your Bedtime. Track three, Real Life. And then Immaturity and So Cold.
Okay. Yeah, what was that?
Not Easy is before me, Immaturity.
Oh, see, damn, I forgot. Like, I forgot Easy.
There's only five.
Oh,
I was about to say, wait a minute, you missed one.
Yeah, see, you did get me. And that's crazy, though, because really that's like my top favorite song on the motherfucking EP, so I don't know how I left that out.
I keep trying to ask him what song he wants to play, and he keeps saying, Easy, Easy, Easy. I'm like... Yeah. Look, I know you've been pushing Easy for two weeks. Right. I get it. Right. You have other tracks, though. Like, I like this. That's one of my favorites.
Not like this. Like this, for sure. Right? Yeah, that's why I had to put that first.
You know, that's a few, and he's just like, yeah, Easy. I'm like,
so. I think the reason I like Easy is just because the video, like, watch when y'all see the video, like, like, I got some dope shit planned for the video. And just in the beginning, if you can remember Easy in the beginning, It's a dude talking on there. He said, "Rise and grind." Mm-hmm. You feel me? No handouts. Yeah, and that's that's my partner, Mike Mack, and rest in peace. You feel me? So like, and that's something that I just got off of his Facebook. Like, I was going through his Facebook. I was really looking for pictures, and then I came across that video, and that shit touched me. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna put this on like damn near every project I got. So y'all gonna be hearing that.
Damn.
Because that's a real statement too. Like, you feel me? Rise and grind. And he said, work hard every day, no handouts. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So,
man, that's true.
So that's partially why that's my favorite song, because that's like a piece of the homie that I could forever carry with me. You feel me? So,
and you say you got these music videos out now. Yeah. People are just tapping in with you right now. Where can they go and watch these music videos? Do they tap your name in, or do you have somewhere they can subscribe?
You can go to the YouTube channel. It's a WTF is a pillow.
What? Yes.
What the fuck is a pillow?
So you. What the fuck is a pillow?
Yeah. What the fuck is a pillow? So that's YouTube. Okay. That's YouTube/ what the fuck is a pillow? Mm-hmm. Or you can just type in Adonis DaHottest, and then that shit gonna pop up.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. And this is what number project of yours? This is gonna be the quiz.
See, with that, I've been dropping CDs since I was like. like 11 years old. Mm-hmm. So
11
for sure, for sure. But I mean, as far as like the projects that like the nowadays, like on all platforms and shit, I could say this is number three. Mm-hmm. This is number three. But okay. But shit, really, like as far as my real catalog and the people who've been following me since I was a little kid, they know that this is like the 20th body of work that I've released.
I would say, because I got like a couple of double albums. I got a few, I got a few albums.
Yeah, I got some work, but right now I'm just trying to catch up to Don Elway catalog, because my nigga Don Elway, he been working.
Yeah, he's been working. He never stopped.
No, he never stops. He's actually the one that kept me going with the music. Like, you feel me? It was a point in time where I was going through bad record deals and production deals and management deals, and I just got fed up with it. You feel me? Like, I kind of turned my back on music, and he was the one like, hey, they got Facebook now. They got Twitter. Make a Twitter. You feel me? Like, I'm already booming on here. Like, I'm like, man, I don't know. You know what I mean? Whatever. I ain't tripping off all that. He's like, nah, you need to get it. You feel me? He was the first one on Pandora. I just got my CD on Pandora. I'm like, okay. I'm like, shit, fuck. He's like, man, you need to get back in the ring. I'm like, for sure. So, you know what I mean? If it wasn't for Elway, I probably wouldn't even be right here right now, honestly.
Elway, no way. He's going to keep you pushing.
Yeah, definitely.
Right? Yeah. All right, well, Roscoe, he's got 6 songs on the track. I don't know if he even gave you 6 songs. I think he said he gave us the album and we looked and there was 1 song, and then he goes, oh.
You know, I'm sleeping that much. You got to excuse me.
Yes, we want more than one.
Right.
I was yelling at the DJ, telling him to search his emails. It must be in spam. I don't know. I deleted. I just have the 1 song. I don't get it.
She did ask me. She said, hold on. So how many songs?
Yeah, I was like, wait a minute. Let me ask him before we...
Right. I've been going hard for that track. I'm trying to tell you. Hey,
send me
easy.
The rest. He sent you. Easy.
Yeah, that's my shit. That's my shit.
So you don't have 6 songs. You have 2 songs. Oh, you have all 6 now. Okay, well, we're going to make sure we get to Easy.
Yeah, definitely.
But we're probably going to close with that song since you're hyping it up so damn much.
That's cool. We can do that.
No, we're going to have to let him wait. In the meantime, so we've already played. Did we play like this? No. We didn't? Oh. You know, I like that one. That's the first one on the album. We don't have to start with that one, but what would you like to
start? I mean, let's go in order.
Okay, let's go in order.
That's cool.
All right, like this. I like this. All right, well, AD, why don't you introduce the first track off of your latest EP, East Daygo Nights.
Hey, this is the first track off my new EP. It's called Like This. Niggas ain't built like this.
Like this, niggas ain't built like this. 40 on me, these niggas ain't built like this. You don't got no diamonds on your wrist like this. Big blue face, honey, I really live like this. Niggas ain't built like this. I'm gonna get chop on you just like this. Niggas fucking up the game like it's 100 new niggas every day. I really do this every day. I'm really with.
Why did you name it East Daygo Nights? What's the purpose of it?
Really, honestly, I've always wanted to name one of my projects that, like a few years ago, like, I actually had a list of project names and shit that I wrote in my notebook. But East Daygo Nights, to me now, like, it just means so much more. Like, now that I'm really, like, free to do whatever I want to do, like, I'm getting back to, like, my roots and just riding around. And, like, you know, there'd be some wild shit that happens on the East Daygo Nights. And every one of them songs basically displays that. You know,
man,
so,
and you're back on sure East Daygo, right? Like, you're from East Daygo.
Yeah, I'm
you
from here
you live
sure.
in the East Daygo area. You represent for the set. Trey 5.
Definitely.
So East Daygo. And you've got, so it seems like you've got Daygo for this EP. You've got Miami for that one. Is it going to be a different location for each one of the EPs that you're releasing?
You know what? I don't know. It just might be. It just might be. I mean, as far as the next one is not Miami. The next one is Las Vegas.
Or Vegas. That's what I meant. Yeah,
so that one is called A Night in Vegas. And the one after that, I mean, y'all just going to have to see. I might end up doing the Miami Nights. But the only reason I did the Vegas Nights was because Notch P, which is the producer on that, he's in Vegas. He's from Daygo, but he's in Vegas. Mm-hmm. So that was literally like a night in Vegas. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's why I called it that. So if I do one for Miami, like, I'm going to have to be in Miami and record with like a Miami producer. Or
business
if I come
trip.
With one of my, yeah, business trip, if I come with one of my producers and we record it entirely in Miami, then that's what you're going to get. But as of right now, it's just East Daygo Nights, and we got a night in Vegas coming soon.
All right.
Top of the spring.
Now, a night in Vegas, are those all one color since you did it all in one night? Or is it multiple colors?
That's multiple colors for sure, okay. All
right.
And for those who's just tuning in, I was explaining to her. And she keeps trying to give my formula, too. For those of you that's just tuning in, I was explaining to her when I actually come with a project, when I'm writing it, when I'm recording it, it's like I see colors. So, you know, like when the project is finished, I put the colors together and see which one meshes with which, you feel me? So that's not a conversation we're going to get into because she keeps trying to get me to talk about my whole process of the color coordination shit.
He stopped the interview to be able to explain
right,
this.
Right.
We're going to get some.
But for those who know me, they know I'm like, you know, like weird when it comes to that. Like, you feel me? Like, this shit is a science for me. Like, mm-hmm. You know, so.
All right, I'm with it. I'm trying to dissect the science
right here.
So we've got the first, well, we played four tracks. The first three were in order. Then we skipped number four. We went to number five because we thought it might be fun to close out on the favorite track that you have.
Easy.
Now, before we get to the last track that we're going to close out the interview with, do you have shout outs? Who do you want to thank recently, right now, all?
Yeah, big shout out to JY Productions. Mm-hmm. I actually recorded this whole entire EP with him. And his mixing and mastering skills are just incredible. Like, it's unmatched, mm-hmm. basically. And JY been rocking with me for a while. So, shout out to JY. Shout out to all the features on the album. Pretty Kai, KC. Even though it's only two features, I'm talking about all the features. Like, it's a gang of motherfuckers.
Hey, they but, all matter.
Yeah, you're not
all
definitely.
All is more than one.
Yeah, big shout out to KC. Mm-hmm. Big shout out to Pretty Kai. Mm-hmm. Definitely appreciate y'all. Shout out to the whole MF squad. Shout out to Uncontrollable Entertainment. Y'all know what's happening. Shout out to the whole Trey Five, too. Mafia moves like a motherfucker.
Right? Yeah. Shout out to Skywalker.
Yeah, shout out to that dude, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. More power to you, man. I wish you all the success, man.
Right? Get your followers up. We got you. We got you. Tap into GoHAM Radio. Send us your mastered MP3 tracks. Request at GoHAM Radio. We do have an international audience. So if you are an artist out there, whether you are signed, unsigned, independent, non-independent, if you just want to get your music out there, send it to us. You can email us requests, that's plural, requests at GoHAMRadio.com. Mastered MP3 format is the format that we take. It's the only format that we take. So if you send us links or any other format, we're not going to play it. And make sure that you send us the track itself not a forwarded email of the track that the producer sent you, because the more forwards you send us, the more of a reduced quality you send. So you should, whatever your producer sends you, your engineer, download that to your phone and then email that to us directly. And besides that, we don't need to know their information. We don't need to know that. We don't know to know their email and the personal conversations that you're having with
them. Get your email game up, man.
Man, come on. Get you somebody who can do something, read you a blog forum, watch a YouTube video, something. Come on now. Maximize this time in quarantine. Are you looking forward to 2021? Are you doing the same plays this year that you did last year to stay afloat? How is that working?
I mean, definitely, like, this year, I think we as a people, like, should all be aware of what's going on, and, like, we should already have a plan just because of last year. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So if you ain't ready for this year, you tripping. I don't know where the hell you been at, but definitely this year, just like I said, we're going to travel where we can travel, mm-hmm. and we're going to book the venues where we can book the venues at. But just really for me, I'm just putting out more music. Mm-hmm. I'm going to just keep putting out more music, more visuals, more content. More shit like this, so, you know, I'm going to just keep my listeners happy.
And you're available on all platforms, right?
Yeah, all platforms.
All right. Mm-hmm. All right. Now, just a quick question. You got stock in GameStop, AMC?
What's up with that? I see AMC went up. I'm actually just getting into the investing in the stocks and the Acorn app and all that. I'm actually just getting into that, so I might have to get some game from you. And everything. I seen that AMC went through the roof.
Okay. Yeah. Ride this one out. Let's see how this goes. It's the stock game is an interesting game.
Yeah, definitely.
And
definitely.
Now secrets are starting to get out on how to play the game.
Yeah.
Cheat codes and all types of things.
Yeah, I need to get ahead of it. I need to get ahead of it with the cheat codes. So we're gonna have to holler when the mics turn off.
You know what?
Off.
We you trade me color schemes and I'll trade you stock picks, okay, and okay. We might call this a deal.
Okay, yeah, for sure. For sure.
We gonna trade something for something.
Yeah, that sound like a deal.
We gotta it look like a checkerboard, but it's really chess.
Hey, yes, chess, man. Not chess.
don't let the color fool you here. All right, I'm Miss Fancy Pants. You've been tapped in with GoHAM Radio for another pop-up exclusive interview.
Yes.
Tonight in the hot seat, we've had Adonis DaHottest. He's just making it hotter up in here. We have been getting a flash of his latest EP, East Daygo Nights. We've played almost every song. We're not going to play every song because if you want to hear every song, you're going to have to go and get that. You're going to have to download that, listen to
just
it, stream it, do all of that. It's available on all platforms. And GoHAM Radio, now that we have more than one or two and a half songs, we got the whole album now. Thank you, AD. I mean, right. You know, Nia did the same thing. We said, okay, send us the album. She was like, okay, we got like five tracks.
Right.
I said, well, where's the other five? She said, you can get them later.
Between the whole camp, Nia didn't drop some high shit. That album was dope. The Difference by Don Elway, that motherfucking album is dope.
Yeah, it's the whole clique. The whole clique definitely has some fire out. So make sure you tap in.
The whole city. The whole city is really putting it out right now. Like on that.
And you know where you can hear all of these local San Diego artists?
GoHAM motherfucking radio.
That is fucking right. Yes. If you don't know, you better ask a fucking D.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, Roscoe. We're going to tap out of this interview, this dope ass interview with a track, not the last track, but the last track we're going to feature. I'm going to let AD introduce this one since this is his favorite one. Go ahead. Lead him into it. Lead him into
what's going on,
not
man?
Temptation.
What's happening with it? It's your boy Adonis DaHottest, and this is my favorite track off the East Daygo Nights EP entitled Easy, featuring Pretty Kai.
Yes. What that mafia shit like, nigga? Got that blower on me, nah, we ain't finna fight, nigga. Better lower your tone before I fuck around and ruin your life, nigga. Knock him down, then go enjoy the rest of my night, nigga. Pop a nigga top like I just did this Remy Martin bottle. The bitches shoes and these Versace loafers that I got on. Niggas ain't fucking with me, this on my mama, I know. And tell that bitch to put cilantro on my lobster taco. Niggas be thinking they tough, but you not fooling me. Don't make me walk up to your front door like I'm a Uber Eats. It should be a crime, all of these diamonds in my jewelry. Listen, I just pulled off your bitch, nigga, while you was asleep. Close eyes ain't never got no bread. These niggas lying in their raps, I did everything I said. Walked out of that prison gate and I bounced back, they try to stop me. Now I'm feeling like Mike Mack in his Maserati. Yeah. Yeah. Talk my shit, nigga, that's easy. Just bought a brand new whip, nigga, that's easy. 100 bands ain't shit, nigga, that's easy. That's easy, yeah, that's easy. Getting money, that's easy. Double up, that's easy. Run it up, that's easy. I'm gonna run it up, that's easy.
That was Easy from East Daygo Nights, the latest EP coming from Adonis DaHottest.
Yes.
Make sure you tap in. You can find it on all streaming platforms. I'm Ms. Fancy Pants. Thank you for tapping in with us. Make sure you tap in to GoHamRadio.com all day, every day on any streaming device that gets Wi-Fi. You can just put in GoHamRadio.com, press the play button. You can tap right in. If you want to check out some of the shows that we have on throughout the week and you've missed their on-air time, go to the on-air tab, scroll down to the show you'd like to tap in with. You can even tap in with every single one of them. They're all in alphabetical order. We know time is of essence sometimes, and you can't always afford the time that we need at the same time. So let's just give you the opportunity to tap in when you can. I'm Miss Fancy Pants. We've had AD right here. Shout out to DJ Roscoe, Mr. Mine. Great day. We've got June in. Man, it is always a pleasure having you
definitely.
In the building.
I appreciate y'all. Y'all show so much love, and I appreciate that.
Man, that's fam right there. So tap in with East Daygo Nights. I'm Miss Fancy Pants.
And y'all didn't tell me I had a celebrity in the studio. God damn it.
You're a celebrity. What's it?
This guy right here was in the Michael. Michael Myers is like my favorite.
I'm
looking at him. I'm like, you look hella familiar. And he's... And I'll play little Michael. And I'm like, yo, I don't know if I'm like, oh, shit, you did.
We got special guests in the building. You never know who's behind the camera. You know who's in front of the camera, but you got to be with the click to know who's behind this shit.
Right,
okay?
Right. Talk that shit.
Right? You letting out all those secrets.
My bad.
Not supposed to let them know we got celebrities in the building. You're not supposed to, I mean, you're the celebrity, right?
Yeah, you know, something like it.
Yeah. All right. Well, make sure you tap happening with GoHAM Radio, where you can get an exclusive interview, not just with AD, but also with Dake Fair, who does play Michael Myers in the Halloween, the latest Halloween by Rob Zombie, along with other exclusive interviews. We've tapped with a lot of people. So I'm Ms. Fancy Pants. Do what it do. Follow, subscribe, all of that, you know, all the little buttons that you see all around. Press them all, click to them all, notifications, all that. Just don't stalk us too heavy, okay? All right, tap in with us next time. I'm Ms. Fancy Pants. Peace.
This has been a GoHamRadio.com exclusive.